The general concept of smart cities is still getting incubated. It's like still very, very raw, and it's like that proverbial elephant. Somebody's looking at the trunk, somebody's looking at the tail, somebody's looking at the main meat, but it's actually complete. It's not just one or two pieces, but there are several issues. It's not just about building up an integrated command and control center. It is not just about slum management or waste management or lights. It is also about the needs and aspirations of the citizens and communities, to be precise, using technology in a manner that the issues they are confronting are properly addressed. For instance, smart city would insist on a lot of convergence of departments, which is not there. Bureaucratic isolation is still there between various departments. It would also mean the capacities of the people, the leaders, and the implementers to understand the domain expertise. It is also about infrastructure, also about e-waste management strategies, which very few people are talking about, because the amount of technology we'll use will generate as much of waste. It is also about data, you know, avalanche, in the sense it more devices means more data, and hence privacy and protection issues. World Bank has been able to so far give us a more demand-centric approach and not a supply-centric approach, which is the right approach in our country. Also, they've been able to create a portal, which is like going to be the repertoire of best practices, which is awesome. With regard to my own institute, as I told you, it's basically a training institute and research and consultancy. So we do all the three things related to smart cities. We do capacity building of the leaders. We do capacity building of the designers, the technocrats, make them aware of all aspects, including cyber security. We also do a lot of impact assessment reviews of the projects which have been rolled out. The theoretical paper tigers are being validated by us. And last but not the least, we are hand-holding several cities to help them create their own blueprints and learn from each other. So we are converging everything. So far, what I figured out from World Bank discussions and other Nordic communities which were here is contextualization and personalization of the initiatives. That means they have very clearly announced in the beginning that one size is not going to fit all, which is very good. So each of us have best practices to offer, but each of us, when we take those practices, we should tune it a bit to our reality. I would want World Bank to look at all aspects of smart city, right from design, that is, help the designers to think of design-centric approach. I want World Bank to keep going downwards up to the grassroots level, help us to create more generic templates and concepts and frameworks which can be established as industry standards, because they have the resources, they have the outreach, they have a say in the processes. And last but not the least, I want World Bank, which they are already doing, to handhold with academia. Because academia would be that neutral, eagle eye watching at the whole rollout.